Hi everyone, in this video we are going to talk about nonlinear regressions. So that includes polynomial regression and log regression. So these are the two specific types of regression models we are going to talk about. And for the polynomial regression, we are going to use a data set called Bluebell. And for the log regression, we are going to use a data set on growth. So I'm going to link those two data sets so that you can download them and you can import them like I am doing here. So I'm choosing import data set from text base. And then I find those data sets. So let me import Bluebell and click import. And then I go to file, import dataset from text base, and then I go to downloads and click growth. So you can see these two datasets are well prepared and we can go ahead and do something with them. So let's start with the polynomial regression. And to build So polynomial regression is in the form of like y is regressed on x and x to the power 2, so the squared of x. You only have one response and one predictor, but you are actually adding a second predictor based on the predictor that you have. So if you look at the data set we have, let's see what we have in the Bluebell data set. If you run the names function, you can find we have two variables. One is abundance and one is light. So this data set is recording the abundance of Bluebell based on different light. So one thing we can do quickly is to draw a plot on the abundance and according to light, and let data equals the Bluebell. So if you draw that quick plot, you will notice it is definitely not a linear regression. It's more like a polynomial because you can see that curved line. So if I draw it a little bit, you can see it is kind of curved like that. So there is no need to draw to fit a model that is a linear regression model. And one thing you can do is to attach the data set so that you can use the variables directly. And you can explore it by running some smoothing splines. So for example, I can do smoothing spline of light and then abundance. And then I let df equals 2. So if I do that, that means I'm making a simple linear regression line. So you can let it equals spline 2. And then you can draw the lines and add them to that scatter plot you had. So, okay, so I named my line spline 2, so I need to be consistent myself. I need to run that line 10, and then I need to add that line. So whenever you get an error message when you use R, don't be scared, because you can read the error message and fix them. So you can see that's the simple linear regression line, the straight line, which is not appropriate for this data set here. Another thing we can check is to copy these two lines and change that df to 3. So when you let df equals 3, that means you are drawing a polynomial line. And if you run these two lines, you are able to see that line is more like the pattern of the dots, right? So if you want to make it look better, you can change the color to blue. So if I change it to blue, you can see the third degree spline is actually much better than the second degree spline. So now you know, probably a linear regression model is not good. You actually need a polynomial regression in order to describe the data. So that's the idea here, when in which situation you probably would need a polynomial regression. So after explore the data, we can start to build the model. And to build that model, we still use LM function, and we put y as the first variable and light as the predictor, and then we add I, and then we put light to the power 2 as our second predictor. So I here is making sure light to the power 2 is actually another predictor. And you can run that. And you can see those are the coefficients that you are estimating. So the formula would be abundance equals negative 2 plus 2 times light minus 0.04 times light to the power 2. So that's the polynomial regression we are building. And you can also name it poly.model, and you can run the summary function of that model so that you can see all the details of this model. You can see all the coefficients with their corresponding t values and p values, and you can see the r squared value is super high for this data. And from the graph, you can also see this blue line describes the data kind of very well. So another thing you can do is to use ggplot to do these things. So it's like after I build the model, I want to draw my model line to the graph. So in order to do that, you would use a package called tidyverse. So let's load the package and then run the drawing lines. Now you can see the polynomial regression actually fits the data very well. So that's it.